الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه. قال الله تعالى في كتابه الكريم: بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا، إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. صدق الله العظيم. Honorable viewers, brothers and sisters in Islam, brothers and sisters in humanity, to all our seekers of knowledge, seekers after the truth, and also to our YouTube and Facebook viewers, I greet you all with the Islamic greetings of peace and love. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace, guidance, mercy of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. Alhamdulillah, praises be to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Welcome to another segment, another episode of our program this evening, Let's Talk Islam with Imran Mohamed, bringing the light of Islam to each and every one of you. We hope and pray, believe in viewers, brothers and sisters, that you are joining us this evening in the best of health and faith by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So as usual, we will commence our program this evening with our opening Quranic recitation to start our program off, inshallah. Remember our golden rules, believe in viewers, brothers and sisters, whenever the Quran is recited, let us listen to it attentively so that you and I will receive some mercy and some blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we have provided the translation of what is being recited so that each and every one of us will have a brief understanding of what is being said by the permission of God Almighty. So without further ado, let us go straight into our opening Quranic recitation, inshallah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا وهو العزيز الغفور الذي خلق سبع سماوات طباقا ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت فارجع البصر هل ترى من فطور ثم ارجع البصر كرتين ينقلب إليك البصر خاسئا وهو حسير ولقد زينا السماء الدنيا بمصابيح وجعلناها رجوما للشياطين وأعتدنا لهم عذاب السعير وللذين كفروا بربهم عذاب جهنم وبئس المصير إذا ألقوا فيها سمعوا لها شهيقا وهي تفور تكاد تميز من الغيظ كلما ألقي فيها فوج سألهم خزنتها ألم يأتكم نذير قالوا بلى قد جاءنا نذير فكذبنا وقلنا ما نزل الله من شيء إن أنتم إلا في ضلال كبير وقالوا لو كنا نسمع أو نعقل ما كنا في أصحاب السعير فاعترفوا بذنبهم فسحقا لأصحاب السعير إن الذين يخشون ربهم بالغيب لهم مغفرة وأجر كبير وأسروا قولكم أو اجهروا به إنه عليم بذات الصدور ألا يعلم من خلق وهو اللطيف الخبير هو الذي جعل لكم الأرض ذلولا فامشوا في مناكبها وكلوا من رزقه وإليه النشور أأمنتم من في السماء أن يخسف بكم الأرض فإذا هي تمور أم أمنتم من في السماء أن يرسل عليكم حاصبا فستعلمون كيف نذير ولقد كذب الذين من قبلهم فكيف كان نكير أولم يروا إلى الطير فوقهم صافات ويقبض ما يمسكهن إلا الرحمن إنه بكل شيء أمن هذا الذي هو جند لكم ينصركم من دون الرحمن إن الكافرون إلا في غرور أمن هذا الذي يرزقكم إن أمسك رزقه بل لجوا في عتو ونفور أفمن يمشي مكبا على وجهه أهدى أمن يمشي سويا على صراط مستقيم قل هو الذي أنشأكم وجعل لكم السمع والأبصار والأفئدة قليلا ما تشكرون قل هو الذي ذرأكم في الأرض وإليه تحشرون ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين قل إنما العلم عند الله وإنما أنا نذير مبين فلما
Alhamdulillah, welcome back to our program, Believing Viewers, Brothers and Sisters. Surely Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God Almighty, has spoken the truth. That's what our opening Quranic recitation to commence our program, to start our program. And what other way to do this, turning our attention to the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Quran. Whatever blessings would have earned from that recitation, whatever blessings would have derived from that recitation, we beg and pray and we make dua, we make prayer that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God Almighty, will shower that upon each and every one of you All our brothers and sisters who may be affected with any difficulty, hardship in life, we beg and pray that the blessings earned will be showered upon each and every one of you by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not to forget, our program this evening, Let's Talk Islam with Imran Mohamed, is coming your way with the kind compliments and the courtesy of NNS Algo's Customs Brokerage Service. Their offices are located at 49 Public Road, Katy in Georgetown, and their branch office at Lot 10A Public Road, Cornelia, Ida, on the west coast of Demerara. VNP Supermarket, they are located at Leonora Public Road on the west coast of Demerara. That is next to the Leonora Police Station, and also Wolf Furniture Store. They are also located at Leonora Public Road on the west coast of Demerara. That is opposite the Leonora Police Station. That is on the west coast of Demerara. Dollar Empire Incorporated and also Dinar Trading. They are located at Lot 1 Lamaha and the Cumming Street, Georgetown. Gafson's Industry as well, believing brothers and sisters. Room Makdum on the east bank of Demerara. The Unlocking Genius, and also in memory of my dear and beloved parents, Bibi Akila Muhammad and Nazar Muhammad, who has gone back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we beg and pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept this initiative and this gesture from all of these brothers and sisters. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them, bless their business, and may this be a means for them to enter into the Jannah and the paradise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Stay tuned, believing viewers, brothers and sisters, for more of Let's Talk Islam with Imran Mohamed. Take a look at our reminder of the day.
People tell you, my main aim in life is to be able to own the three big buildings in the center of Tobago. I hope Tobago has big buildings, inshallah. My aim in life is to own those three buildings. So he starts working at the age of 10, 15. Perhaps he is so focused and dedicated. Listen to this example. So focused and dedicated that at the age of 50, he owns those three buildings. Wow. What was required to do that? Focus and dedication. Two things. He knew what he wanted. He was focused on it. And he was dedicated. He made sure he got it. And then at the age of 60, the uncle on his deathbed, may Allah protect us all. And then he says, wow, I really am excited. I've accomplished everything in my life. I wanted those three buildings and I got them. Now I'm dying. Goodbye. Would that be a foolish person? Yes, very foolish. Why? Nobody's going to shove those three buildings into your grave and tell the angels, hey, I had the three buildings. No way, not at all. No one can write you a certificate and stick it on your chest to say, hey, angel of death, or the angels who are going to come and ask questions, this man, he was dedicated and focused, those three buildings, he owned them, so now give him easy passage into heaven. Doesn't happen that way, not at all. But when we are focused and dedicated to earn the building of the Akhirah, to earn that which is in paradise, we will achieve it, and it will come into our grave with us, and later on we will see it and we will live in it and we will be smiling. Now, what does that mean? Do not die except in the condition of submission. It means lead your life in such a way that, as you know, death can overtake you at any time. If it were to overtake you right now, would you be amongst those who are submitters unto your own Creator? If the answer is yes, then you are very fortunate. And this is why don't wait to turn to Allah. You know, if we wait to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we wait to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we may never ever get that opportunity. So one thing we should never wait for is to turn to Allah. When we do not have proper objectives and goals in life, we waste a lot of time. We don't know what exactly we want. We don't know where exactly we want to reach. And we don't work towards it. Some people know, I'd like to do this, I'd like to do that. And they don't work towards it. If you don't work towards it, you're wasting time. You're wasting all your time. Because before you know it, time would be finished and you would not have achieved what you wanted. So it's important for us to have proper objectives. And secondly, a point I touched on, your company, your companions, they are also a big obstacle. If you mix with like-minded people who have similar goals and objectives, you will get there with greater ease. Also, being involved in that which is glamorous, that which shines, that which glitters, and chasing it. We heard about the dunya. Those who chase the dunya, let me inform you, it has no end. And we like fools keep running behind. You know, I pictured it once in my mind. I'd seen a load of rats running behind a cheese, a piece of cheese. And as they got the cheese, there was one smelling stronger in front. So they threw this one and they carried on. And they threw the other one, but eat from this cheese and be full at least. I hope you understand what I'm saying. You've got your cheese, the first cheese you've got. And what happens? It goes to motor vehicles, it goes to cell phones. And after that, it goes to your spouse. Why? You've got a wife. Oh, she's 1990 model. I need, now, I need a better, a later model. Why? You developed your habit of wanting the latest. So when you see your wife, she no longer appeals to you. When you see your husband, he no longer appeals. Why? Just like your phone. It no longer appeals. I seen a dude down the road with a better jeans, halfway down his butt, mashallah. May Allah protect us. Who you are and your role that you are meant to play, your objective is made by other people, your friends, your peers, and the media in particular. Every time there is a movie, they come up with a new type of dress code and a new hairstyle, and then you have all these hedgehogs in the classroom. Another very, very important point. Some people have a habit of starting something, before they've finished it, they start something else. And starting a third thing before they finish the second. When you do something, do it properly, complete it, and then go for something else. This means when you do something, do a thorough job. Some people, and I do know, they start a course 2 years down the line. No, I don't want to do this course. Go to another one. They do another course and 2 years down the line, I don't want to do. Well, look, if it happened to you once, probably maybe it was the wrong field. Maybe you've now chosen the right one, but finish something. Finish it. And your best bet is choose properly from the beginning. Always up. But that's what it's all about. Time is never enough. Never ever. Let's use it, inshallah, in the right direction. Let us make sure that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning let us make sure that we call out to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us goodness. Once we have used our time properly and we learn to be systematic in our life, we will feel so good. We will be able to achieve our goals. You know, we will be able to achieve something in life, be happy. We will be able to make sure that every moment we have had has been used in the right direction. And this is why don't wait to turn to Allah. You know, if we wait to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we wait to turn to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we may never ever get that opportunity. So one thing we should never wait for is to turn to Allah. You know, the sisters, subhanallah, even the brothers, sometimes there's a religious decision we need to make. Make it now. Don't say, okay, I'm not, you know, holy enough. I still want to enjoy my life. I still want to, you know, I cannot go for Hajj now. I still need to do this. No. It must happen now, N-O-W. If it doesn't come now, it may never ever come. There are so many examples of it. So if you want to get to a higher spiritual level, let it happen now.
Alhamdulillah, welcome back to our program. That was our reminder of the day. Whatever information is given on a program, believe in brothers and sisters, we ask that you try to act upon it. Try to inculcate this in your life. You're viewing our program, believe in brothers and sisters. Then share this with those who are absent by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Remember, you can continue to view our program right here on channel 69 at 8:30 p.m. every Monday evenings. You can subscribe to our channel on YouTube. You can like our page on Facebook. And also stay connected this Ramadan via our WhatsApp group. You can be part of our WhatsApp group, inshallah, through telephone number 622-6842. That is 622-6842. And you can have your various reminders with regards to moon sighting updates, with regards to halal, haram, and many other amazing issues with regards to this beautiful deen of ours. So stay connected this Ramadan, believing brothers and sisters, through our WhatsApp group. 622-6842 is the number to subscribe by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, God Almighty, continues to shower each and every one of us with various blessings, various favors, various ni'mah from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. God Almighty, through His infinite mercy, has caused each and every one of us to complete the month of Jumada al-Thani. This, believing brothers and sisters, was the sixth month of the Islamic year, alhamdulillah. And now we are in the blessed month of Rajab. This is the seventh month of the Islamic year. and one of the sanctified and sacred months that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained for each and every one of us. We actually sighted the moon last Friday evening. So the month of Jumada al-Thani completed 29 days. And now we are in the month of Rajab. Let us go to our moon sighting update for some additional information on this.
Gönüllerde hasretin var Yürekler aşkınla çarpar Sensiz dünya bizlere dar Selam sana ey kutlu yar With submission, faith and patience You conveyed the noble message Brought the light through your guidance Peace be upon you, my beloved Ya Habibi, Ya Muhammad Ya Nabi, Salam Alaikum
Yes, Alhamdulillah, the moon was sighted, believing brothers and sisters. We are in the month of Rajab. Like I've mentioned before, this is one of the sacred and the sanctified months that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained for each and every one of us. And so, what does this mean, believing brothers and sisters, for us believers, as Muslims? As people of God, it therefore means that the month of Ramadan is approximately 2 months away from us by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so as Muslims, as believers, we should utilize this month of Rajab in a way to prepare ourselves for the coming month, which is the intervening month, the month of Sha'ban, and then the month of Ramadan that follows after that. This is the month, believing brothers and sisters, as the scholars and the ulama have mentioned, that is the month of sowing the seed. It is the month of planting and preparing. Like a farmer, for example, who plants his crop, it therefore means that he has to prepare his land. He has to make sure that everything is in order so that when he put that seed in, when he put in his crops, for example, when he sow that seed, then in the coming months, he will be able to reap what he has put in. So similarly, believing brothers and sisters, this is an amazing time, the month of Rajab, whereby we can able to recalibrate our spiritual compass. We need to recalibrate our spiritual compass in this month of Rajab, preparing ourselves for the month of Sha'ban, for the month of Ramadan, by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A beautiful supplication, a beautiful dua that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make when he sighted the moon for Rajab. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab. Wa Sha'ban, O Allah, bless us in the month of Rajab, wa Sha'ban, and the month of Sha'ban, wa balighna Ramadan, and allow us to enter the month of Ramadan, expand our life so that we will have that life to enter the month of Ramadan. And so this is a beautiful supplication that I encourage each and every one of us to recite in this month of Rajab, insha'Allahu ta'ala. Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa balighna Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us in this month of Rajab, bless us in the coming month of Sha'ban and the month of Ramadan, insha'Allahu ta'ala. Take a look at our hadith of the day, believing brothers and sisters. And when we come back right here in our program, Let's Talk Islam with Imran Mohamed, we'll share some more additional information concerning this beautiful and sanctified month that we are in, the month of Rajab.
Gönüllerde hasretin var Yürekler aşkınla çarpar Sensiz dünya bizlere dar Selam sana ey kutlu yar With submission, faith and patience You conveyed the noble message Brought the light through your guidance
Welcome back to our program, believing viewers, brothers and sisters. That was our hadith of the day, alhamdulillah. golden advice from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Remember, you can continue to view our programs right here, our channel 69, at 8:30 p.m. every Monday evenings, inshallah. And we have our program on YouTube as well. All those brothers and sisters who may not have the time to view our program on the television, then you can subscribe to our channel on YouTube, and you can have the various programs there that are uploaded by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Facebook page as well, and not to forget our WhatsApp group. You can subscribe to that WhatsApp group through telephone number 622-6842, and you can stay connected this Ramadan. You can have your various reminders with regards to moon sighting update, with regards to halal, haram, with regards to other issues concerning this beautiful deen of ours, by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Our program this evening is coming your way with the kind compliments and the courtesy of NNS Algo's Customs Brokerage Service, VNP Supermarket, Wolf Furniture Store, The Unlocking Genius, Dinar Trading, Dollar Empire Incorporated, and also Gafson's on East Bank of Demerara, in memory of my dear and beloved parents, Nazar Mohammed and Akil Mohammed, by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. God Almighty mentions in the Quran, believing viewers, brothers and sisters, advising us and telling us with regards to the sacredness and the sanctity of these blessed months that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ordained for each and every one of us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran, إِنَّ عِدَّةَ الشُّهُورِ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ إِثْنَ عَشَرَ شَهْرًا فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ. Indeed, the number of months with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is 12. And this has been recorded in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is known as the Lawhul Mahfuz, the preserved tablet. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us that the number of months, it is 12, that has been recorded in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the preserved tablet, يوم خلق السماوات والأرض, from the moment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth. So therefore, these sacred and sanctified months, which are four in numbers, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, منها أربعة حرم, out of these 12 months that has been ordained, منها أربعة حرم, four of them are considered sacred. Therefore, believing brothers and sisters, these four and sacred and sanctified months has been made sacred and sanctified from the moment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth. It has not been made secret in this particular year, the year 2021, or it has not been made secret in the year 2020, or the year after that, or the year before that, subhanallah. But generally, believing brothers and sisters, it has been made secret from the moment Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the heavens and the earth. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he advises us with regards to these four sacred and sanctified months. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he says that three out of these 4 months run in succession. So we have the month of Dhul-Qadah, the month of Dhul-Hijjah, that is the month of Hajj, the season of Hajj, the month of Qurbani. We have the month of Muharram, which is the first month of the Islamic year. So these are the 3 months that comes in succession. And then he continues and he says that the other one that is by itself, it is the month of Rajab. Alhamdulillah, we are in the month of Rajab, the sacred and sanctified months. And it therefore means, believing brothers and sisters, that we should not wrong ourselves in these sacred and sanctified months. And this was the advice from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when God Almighty mentions to us by advising us, and do not wrong yourselves in these sacred and sanctified months, subhanallah. This is a time when battles were prohibited in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. In fact, believing brothers and sisters, the month of Rajab has been given the name or referred to as Rajab Muddar. Why? Simply because there was a tribe known as the tribe of Muddar that used to give the month of Rajab its true rights, that used to give the sanctity and the sacredness of this month of Rajab. They used to respect the month of Rajab. When the month of Rajab entered, subhanallah, then they will put down all their ammunition, they will put down all their fighting equipment, subhanallah, and they will give the month of Rajab its due right, its respect. And so as a result of that, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam referred to the month of Rajab as the month as Rajab Muddar, subhanallah. This is the time, believing brothers and sisters, that we are in the month of Rajab. it is a time where we need to sow the seed. As the scholars of the past, they have mentioned that Rajab, it is a month of planting the seed. And then the month of Sha'ban, which is the intervening month between the month of Rajab and the month of Ramadan, the month of Sha'ban is the month to water that seed that you have planted. And then the month of Ramadan is the month where we will now reap what we have planted, what we have sown, subhanAllah. So therefore, as believers, as Muslims, that we are in the month of Rajab, then we need to recalibrate our compass. We need to recalibrate our religious and spiritual compass, subhanAllah. Putting ourselves into perspective, believing brothers and sisters, preparing ourselves for the month of Ramadan. Just like how a farmer, for example, will prepare his land when he's now going to plant his crop, he's now going to put in back his crop. He will now prepare his land. He will make sure that the land has enough earth. He will make sure that the land has enough water. He will make sure that there is enough fertilizer, subhanAllah, so that when he put that seed in and he plant that seed, it therefore means that in the coming months, he will now have to water that seed that he has planted. And then after that, subhanAllah, then when that seed blossoms into a beautiful plant, then he will be able to reap what he has put in, subhanAllah. So a person, for example, who has not put in anything proper, a person who, for example, who has not made any sort of preparations for his planting, then when it is time for reaping, then he will not reap anything that is wholesome. He will not reap anything that is good, that his crops, his products will be inferior. Isn't that so? Simply because he had not put in, from the inception, he had not made any sort of preparations for when the time of reaping come, then he will reap something that is good. As against a person who makes that preparation, he prepares his land, he makes that effort of making sure that the seed is put in, that it is watered properly, it is looked after, and it is cared for. So when the time of reaping comes, believing brothers and sisters, then you will reap something that is good, you will reap something that is wholesome, you will reap something that is very handsome. So similarly, the scholars of the past, they say that the month of Rajab, it is a month where we will sow the seed. So we need to recalibrate our spiritual compass in the direction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to first and foremost focus on our salah. We need to put a lot of emphasis on our salah, subhanAllah. Because in the month of Ramadan, it is a month where we will be performing our salah. We'll be fasting by day, and then we'll be performing our Taraweeh Salah by night, subhanAllah. And so a person who does not make any sort of preparations in the month of Rajab, and then follow that up in the month of Sha'ban, then come the month of Ramadan, when all of these acts of worship and devotion come together, then it will be very difficult on such a person. It will be very burdensome on such an individual. Many times we see that when we enter the month of Ramadan, the first few days, subhanAllah, then a person has that very high momentum. That person has a very high energy, subhanAllah. But then as we advance further into the month of Ramadan, then our momentum drop, our energy, it reduces. And so the masjid and the masajid becomes very, a lot of people start to stay away from the masjid and the masajid. In the month of Ramadan, the first few days, the masjid and the masajid are packed. But then when we go into the month of Ramadan, then we see the crowd, it starts to reduce, subhanAllah. And that is because we have not made any sort of proper preparations in the month of Rajab and follow that up in the month of Sha'ban. So the first thing that we need to focus on, believing brothers and sisters, is get our salah up to date. We need to start performing our salah, our five daily salawat. If you, believing brothers and sisters, are not people who are perform their Fajr Salat in Jama'ah, if you're not the people of Fajr Salah, then make that effort now in the month of Rajab to start performing your Fajr Salah in Jama'ah, insha'Allah ta'ala. Let us try to stitch in, insha'Allah, some Nawafil prayers as well, some extra prayers as well. So we focus on our Salah in this month of Rajab and also fasting, insha'Allah ta'ala. Even though there is no specific form of worship and ibadah that has been prescribed in this month of Rajab, but the month of Ramadan, it is the month of fasting, it is the month of Quran, reciting the Quran. And so we do not want to wait on the first of Ramadan to start making preparations for fasting, to start making preparations for the recitation of the Quran. No. We need to make these preparations now, insha'Allah ta'ala. Familiarize yourselves with the recitation of the Quran. Many a time when the month of Ramadan comes to an end, then you and I do not pick up the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till the next Ramadan, till the next year's Ramadan, subhanAllah. So to avoid these lapses, believing brothers and sisters, then let us make that preparation now in this month of Rajab. Familiarize yourself with the Quran, insha'Allah ta'ala, so that when we enter the month of Ramadan, then we'll be fully equipped to recite the entire Quran in the month of Ramadan. In order for us to do this, we need to recite at least one page of the Quran every single day. At least one page of the Quran, insha'Allah. And when we act upon this and when we be consistent upon this, then believe me, brothers and sisters, we will be able to recite the entire Quran in the month of Ramadan, insha'Allah. Be in the habit of giving a lot of sadaqah, a lot of charity. Remember, in the month of Ramadan is where we will want to give that zakah, we will want to give that charity, insha'Allah ta'ala. And so let us make this a habit now that we are in this month of Rajab by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when we do this, believing brothers and sisters, we follow these acts of worship and these acts of devotion. We follow that up in the month of Sha'ban. Like the scholars, they say that the month of Sha'ban is where we water that seed that we have made preparations for in the month of Rajab. And so when we recalibrate our spiritual compass in the month of Rajab, and then we follow that up in the month of Sha'ban, then come the blessed month of Ramadan, insha'Allah ta'ala, we will be able to reap those beautiful reward and those beautiful and amazing reward that has been promised by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a sacred and sanctified month. Not only that, believing brothers and sisters, but the month of Rajab is a month that houses two beautiful incidents that took place in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And one of the incidents we will be hearing much about, insha'Allah, in the coming week, it is known as the Isra and the Mi'raj, that beautiful ascension of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that ascended to the heavens, whereby Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that gift of salah. Like any other form of worship and ibadah, like that of fasting, for example, came from Jibreel alayhi salatu wasalam through revelation. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran with regards to fasting, but with regards to salah, this is an act of worship and devotion that has been given directly by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And this is one of the incidents, insha'Allah, that we will like to discuss in our future programs by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then the second incident that took place in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that happened in this month of Rajab is known as the Battle of Tabuk. Yes, believing brothers and sisters, this was the battle that took place in the month of Rajab, the ninth year after the Hijrah, subhanAllah. And so in our coming programs, insha'Allah, we would like to shed some light with regards to the Isra and the Mi'raj, that great ascension of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and this battle, the Battle of Tabuk, that took place in the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So insha'Allah, it is time that we bring our curtains down on our program. Remember our beautiful dua that was recited by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa ballighna Ramadan. Let us try to inculcate this in our lives, insha'Allah. Let us try to act upon this and practice upon this lesson, believing brothers and sisters. Recite this constantly in the month of Rajab, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us in this month of Rajab, the month of Sha'ban, and allow us to enter the blessed month of Ramadan, insha'Allah ta'ala. Continue to view our program, believing brothers and sisters, next week Monday, right here on channel 69 at 8:30 p.m. Not to forget our YouTube channel, our Facebook page, and also stay connected this Ramadan through our WhatsApp group. 622-6842 is the number to subscribe, insha'Allah ta'ala. So until next week Monday, may the peace, guidance, mercy of God Almighty be with each and every one of you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I leave you now with our quotation of the day, insha'Allah.
Yerde hasretin var, yürekler aşkınla çarpar. Sensiz dünya bizlere dar. Selam sana ey kutlu yar. With submission, faith and patience, you conveyed the noble message. Brought us light through your guidance. Peace be upon you, my beloved. Ya Habibi, Ya Muhammad. Ya Nabi, salam alayka. Ya Rasul, salam alayka. Ya Habib, salam alayka. Salawatullah alayka.
بذكر الرسول تشحذ الهمة يا ربي بجاه النبي أزيح الغمة يا ربي.
Hey everybody, it's me, Lolly, the one and only.
Haha, I'm telling you today about phones. You see all the different type of phone. What's this? This is not a phone, this is a remote. Oh, put away now. Any type of phone you got and it need to unlock, if the phone need to unlock or anything in the phone need to unlock, then you got to come to the unlocking genius. This one can unlock anything, any phone, network lock, password lock, Google lock, Samsung lock, computer lock, iCloud lock. Not people can do this unlocking, but this one will unlock all of the phone anytime, anyway, all the time.
So any type of phone for unlock, you call 626-4772 or 693-2204. Unlocking genius.
So remember, unlock any phone, unlock anything on the phone, you call the number and get your phone unlocked. But the only thing we don't unlock is thieving phone.
Now you can really go shopping in Lenora at V&P Supermarket 20 North Lenora Public Road. Come in and enjoy great prices on the widest range of groceries, beverages, frozen meats and vegetables and ice cream too, even food for your pets. Get detergents and bathroom soaps and cleaners, the full range and all the brands. Pots and pans for the kitchen, cutlery and crockery for dining, and all the household items you need to make home so comfortable. The ladies will love our cosmetics collection, perfect for gifts for special occasions and just what you promised yourself. V&P Supermarket 20 North Lenora Public Road, West Coast, Demerara.
Gaffers, manufacturers of the perfect concrete hollow block in sizes 4 inches and 6 inches, certified by the Ghana National Bureau of Standards and hydraulically tested by the University of Guyana to 2,000 pounds per square inch. Pallet packed and shrink wrapped for easy transportation too. So get your supplies of the best quality made concrete hollow blocks in Guyana and also get a 12.5% discount. For superior service, quality and competitive prices, visit Gaffer's Mega Complex at Macdu and our outlets of Rose Hall, Kanji, Bedford Acting, Means, Land of Canaan and Perica.
Yerde hasretin var, yürekler aşkınla çarpar. Sensiz dünya bizlere dar. Selam sana ey kutlu yar. With submission, faith and patience, you conveyed the noble message. Brought us light through your guidance. Peace be upon you, my beloved. Ya Habibi, Ya Muhammad. Ya Nabi,
السلام عليك